Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel NetCast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Welcome back to the Mr. Excel NetCast. I'm Bill Jelen. This is episode 1013. We're going back to episode 993. Correct a couple of things back there. In 993, I talked about how to create a dynamic range that would automatically extend this chart. And as you add more data, it extends the chart. Great. I got a note from Andre in England, and Andre said, well, hey, that method that you used is fine, but it's going to keep growing forever. What if you need to show just the last 6 or 10 points? And Andre provided a great set of formulas here. So we use the same name range that we use in 993, but instead we're subtracting. So if we want to look for the last 6 points, C uses minus 7 here for the last 10 points, minus 11. So we're subtracting one more than before. Let's give it a try here. We'll type December and a value of 9.1. And you see that the chart automatically shifted when we go look at that formula. It is indeed grabbing the last 6 values. And then in 994, I showed a faster way to do this using Ctrl T in Excel 2007, Ctrl L in Excel 2003. Tracy, who manages all of our VBA projects, wrote to me and said, hey, did you actually test that before you put it in the podcast? And, well, you know, sure enough, I did test it in 2007. And even here in 2003, I've defined this list using Control L. And you'll see that if I add a brand new region, Canada, the chart does update like I advertised. Let's put 100 in there. However, unlike Excel 2007, when we add a new column, so here, May, the list does update like I thought it would, but the chart does not update. So in Excel 2003, the feature is there, but it is half there. It's great if you're adding new rows, not so great if you're adding new columns. Of course, if you're going to be adding new columns, you could always just copy and paste special transpose and then create a list, and you see that the feature will work there. So thanks to Andre from England, sending him an Excel master pin. Thanks to Tracy in South Dakota for catching me on not actually checking my work back in Excel 2003. And I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another NetCast from Mr. Excel. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another NetCast from Mr. Excel.